It's a big day for the Riverside Royals as we play maybe the worst team we've played so far. Certainly the worst team, actually, in FCS Southeast. Now, I'm not actually sure what FCS team this is supposed to be. Like, with the Bison of North Dakota State, it's pretty easy to tell who we're, like, playing, because it's, like, very obvious who it's based off of. But I don't really know who the FCS Southeast Colonels would be. Sure, you guys might have an idea about that down in the comment section below. But I've taken some feedback from the comments to make this series at least a little bit more competitive right now. I've raised the player minimum speed threshold to 10. Apparently, that plays better. And these are the updated sliders. You know, it's still going to be far from easy. Nothing is higher than 50. But hopefully, this should make the gameplay a little bit better. But we do have to realize that the team that we have is really, really bad right now. So it's still going to be very, very challenging to beat good teams. But we should at least have a chance now, right? And for recruiting, I've been adding players, you know, up and down all the time. Let me back out of this real quick because we can see who's visiting. We have a couple of visits coming. We have Joe Downing and Kyle Holloway. So Joe Downing, his visit, we need 3 sacks with the D-line. 2 tackles for loss with the D-line. We'll get an extra 450 points if we do both of those things. And we're playing the worst team we've played. I think that's doable. I really do. The other player, is it Brandon Eaton? No, it's Kyle Holloway. Right. So we need to run for over 100 yards and pass for over 250. Passing for over 250 could be a real challenge. But those are the 2 players coming today. The first ever visits. Joe Downing would be a big one to get. We're locked right now with Colorado. It's going to be a really, really tight race to see who can get him. So we need the extra points. He's going to be a tough player to get. I'm just going to say that right now. It's going to be a really tough player to get. Colorado, I think, has the advantage in a lot of different departments. But with Kyle Holloway, never really put too many points into him. Just gave him a scholarship and said, hey, you want to come? And he's like, all right, sure. And he's not too bad. He's really not too bad. We also have a bunch of new guys added to the bottom of the list here. I think these players in general had lower lock percentages. A couple 2-star or 3-star players, a couple 4-star players. We don't actually know where we are on that yet, but we're going to try and sneak in and steal these guys. Nick Jackson would be an especially big one to get, as he's a 75 overall 4-star, currently looking to stay in state at Arkansas, but we're going to try and steal him, bring him out west. And then we have, you know, a number of other players. We're looking at quarterbacks quite a bit. I've decided to throw some points into Andy Byers. He's a JUCO player, but he's only a 2-star, right? Like, I would be cool with starting this guy just to give us a really good chance of actually winning games. And it's clear that this is, you know, someone that we can really run read option with and do so successfully. Really good speed, break tackle, spin move, carrying. Like, trucking doesn't even look too bad. So Andy Byers can be a really fun quarterback to actually play with. Don't really know much about his passing right now. And just still trying to get some other guys as well. We've gone into the lead on Bruce Clemens from Phillipsburg, New Jersey. I'm from New Jersey. I have no idea where that is. No idea, but he looks amazing. Really solid zone. Awesome speed. Clearly an amazing player. So he would be a huge get. And the other big one is Ryan Davis. I've decided to not put points into him anymore just because we have such a massive lead and the projected cutoff has us, you know, like greatly out in front. So I think this is just a player we're going to get. He's 85% locked. I think we're going to get him. So I've taken points out of him and put him into other players that we're really trying to get. Still trying to get Patrick Payne. I'm putting 500 points in for a 66 overall guard. He could end up being better than that. Hopefully he is a gem, but I really don't know. He visits in week 12, but it's just between us and San Jose State right now. So that's where we are on the updated recruiting. And let's go ahead and pop into this game against FCS Southeast. They're 63 overall, by far the worst team we've played so far in the Dynasty. This could be our first win. And for a little extra hype, we're going with the blackout jerseys. It's all white versus all black here. Okay, maybe we should rephrase that. It's all black uniforms versus the all white uniforms. And we, of course, have the blackout. The fans didn't choose to participate. But this is the first time you guys have seen these. I think they look very, very nice. But hopefully our performance is just as nice, if not nicer. So we need Dorian Hood, Trey Battle, Brett Claxton to come out here and help crown the Kings. Lead this team to a victory and raise the crown at the end of the game. Let's get it. Live from Royal Field, it's FCS Southeast traveling to play the currently winless Riverside Royals. That changes today. Let's get that football and let's score. Kenny Bush is back. He's going to take this one out. Oh, breaks a tackle and takes a big shot. Only back to the 20. Also, I was reading comments. I don't know why some people were thinking, like, they were trying to tell me that in college you only need 1 foot in. Do you think that's news to me? Like, this is general confusion on my end that people think that's new information to me. So we're going to throw outside, and Dorian Hood looking like his usual self. Like, I wonder what I'm going to try to be told next, that, oh, if somebody's knee hits the ground, they're down. Like, oh, wow. So we're going to break a sack and throw it away. Okay, not a great start to this drive. We just got saved there. The play action, the routes were going across the other side of the field. And we're a better running team. Decided to start out with a pass, and then I felt forced to pass. Probably not four down territory. We just need somebody to make a play. We got the running back, Trey Battle, and there's not really anywhere to go. Bad drive. I needed to start with running the ball, and I didn't. Remember, our goals for the game, 250 passing yards, 100 rushing yards, and defensively, it's with the defensive line, we need 3 sacks and or 2 sacks and 3 tackles for loss, something like that, but with D linemen. So if we get a sack with Brett Claxton or Carlos Oakley, doesn't count for anything. Tackles for losses too, as Grimes going to take it. He's going to break a Justin Santos tackle and go for 18. Also, every time I restart this game, the commentators are back on. It never saves those settings. So sorry if that was a little bit annoying to listen to, but I caught it real early into the game. Just is what it is for the start of that one. Griffin, the tight end in motion. They got an H-back in there as well. And they're going to throw, and way out of the back of the end zone. Ed Arnold's first pass. Just a throwaway, really. It's an end around. They're going to hand it off to Harden. We got to make a tackle here. Santos. Oh, my goodness, dude. How do we not get a tackle on that? That's so bad. Okay, they're throwing out some very interesting formations and interesting plays so far. I'm trying to see who's going to get the ball here. Throwaway kind of again by Ed Arnold. That one maybe was actually just a bad pass. And this is a bad team that we're playing. But they kind of drove down the field real well. We're going to clean some things up. And they should take the lead probably here. 3-0. Yep, kick is good. All right. Offense needs to step up. It's going to be a much better second drive for us. We're going to try a speed option with a slot motion here and see if we can pick up some good yards. We're going to go up the middle and just a nice play by the defensive end. Dorian Hood is not the fastest, so that's not a good start to our run game here. Maybe a more traditional run with Trey Battle is going to do the trick. I tried to juke. It just didn't do anything. 3rd and 8. All right. Drive number 2 is proving to be not much better than drive number 1. It is 3rd down, though. We could very well move the chains here. We're going to try and throw that ball. Tight window. Burgess can't hold on. We had a vertical route going up the seam. I just didn't think that Dorian Hood had the arm, so I opted for a safer throw. It was a tight window pass, but the pass got there. Eric Burgess just didn't catch it, was the big problem there. So drive 2 is not better than drive 1. Read option, make a play. Zaire Cruz can't. Young can't. Tried to dive at his legs there and make the play. Thankfully, Ezekiel Sims was there and brought him down. I might try to run a lot of 5-2. I don't know if that's going to count. Yeah, it definitely will, because there's 5 defensive linemen in there. And we need those plays with D-line. As James got beat, Malik James just torched down the sideline. And Brandon Kelly has a huge catch. just don't have the speed to run with guys. That's currently the problem with the entire team, really. And especially there, we just got crushed. Yeah, but running 5-2 and just trying to get pressure with the D-line and tackles for loss will be the way as they just run up the middle. Rob Grimes gets the touchdown, and FCS Southeast will take a 10-0 lead. We're going to try a read option here. Let's get something going with Trey Battle, please. Okay, we're going to take it with the quarterback, Hood. He gets 4. It's not a bad start, okay? We're on pace for a first down currently. And of course, the CPU has us come out from empty. We're going to streak Elgin Collins. With the right coverage, it's going to be wide open. We got to throw that. Dorian Hood just didn't have the arm strength, man. We had a step. It's got to hit these throws. And we have to recruit a new quarterback. That much is obvious. Slant. Okay, that is such a bad pass. Yeah, he's so bad. Slant wide open. First down guaranteed. Bad throw. Punt number 3. Now, I do feel a little bit silly here with engage 8 when they have 4 receivers. We're just going to try to get there really, really quickly. And it didn't work, but you know what? It wasn't so bad, especially with the deep zones. We do have a little bit of protection back there. Just try cover 1. We need these defensive linemen to win these battles. You got 1-on-1. We need you to win some 1-on-1 battles. He's just going to run. Oh my goodness. We are getting killed right now. Huge 3rd down and 2. Bring it up, Claxton. We're going to show blitz. Of course, it's not coming, though. And the quarterback's going to try and take off. And he got sacked. That's going to be a D-tackle sack. J.D. Glover. That's 1 for the D-line. I really think 5-2 is going to be the way to get that done. So we're going to run 5-2 pretty much for the rest of the game. And have this offense get alive at some point. That'd be real nice. Bush broke a tackle. Nice return on the punt. 23 yards. Let's wake up, offense. Let's go. Okay, well, that draw was completely doomed from the start. They just crashed hard and crushed us. I swear, it's harder to move the ball on this team than any other team we've played so far. We're going to get out of the pocket here with Hood. He's not going to get sacked. We got a block. Dorian Hood lowers the shoulder, went through a man. But out of bounds, 23-yard gain for Dorian Hood. Surprised he wasn't sacked there. Really surprised he wasn't sacked. And off to Trey Battle. Just got to get more yards. That sweep has been pretty, you know, ineffective for us so far. Another run. We actually got blockers this time. Trey Battle to the outside. He's got the first down on a gain of more than 10. You know, they keep blitzing some of these linebackers. Might be a good idea to get some short passes out here. We're going to try and take off and just run with Dorian Hood. I really wanted to throw one of those short hitches. The problem with that is that they were too close to each other. So you had one guy that was essentially taking away 2 routes. Didn't really feel comfortable throwing the ball into traffic, especially with the accuracy concerns of Dorian Hood. We're going to call a read option. We got blockers. Hood up the middle. We don't slide. 9-yard gain. I'm telling you, once I get actual speed at the quarterback position, it is over for these defenses. It is over. I'm going to be scrambled like some eggs. Scrambling like a chef. There's something there. I'm not going to find it. That much is obvious. Coming up to the end of the first quarter, would love to score a touchdown on this final play here. Not that it really matters. We're rolling out. We're running with Hood. Dorian Hood! First down! We just can't throw the ball, so why bother? Make them drop their guys back into coverage because they're run defense has been awesome so far. So get their guys back in coverage and then take off. Their D-line has not been able to contain Dorian Hood with like 60-something speed. Read option again up the middle. Hood is into the end zone. There is a flag. It's a really bad time for a hold. Brandon Smith, the right tackle. That killed us. Now backed up to the 12. We're going to try a screen here. We're going to get a little crazy. Okay, that was really awful. just trying to figure out ways that we can move the football and not really throw the ball far. Try this halfback swing. You had to block one guy. You had to block one guy, and it didn't happen. Third and goal. Would love a touchdown here. I don't know what field goal range is. And, I mean, just couldn't get the throw off. Probably would have been better off scrambling outright. We'll try a 29-yarder. The weather looks pretty good here. Minimum wind. I just don't think my kicker has it. Kick is up. And good! I didn't think we'd hit a field goal the entire year. I did not think we'd hit a field goal the entire year, and that one sails through. Just a touchdown game. And it's a bruised sternum for Dorian Hood. He's out for the next quarter. Come on, man. What is this, Madden 22 with the bruised sternums? Oh, he's gonna be off to the races here. Malik James got to save a touchdown. Phillips just got dragged down the field. That's a 60-yard return by Brandon Kelly. It's going to be a pitch left. Oh, they have numbers out there. Santos. That's a really nice way to get outside and save a huge game. But we got to keep sending pressure. It's the way we've had success so far, too. So I'm not really even worried about doing it. We're going to allow big plays either way. If we can force the football out quickly, it's a little wishbone action. Oh, what an option play. Oh, my goodness. DeAngelis in motion. I thought it was going to be a draw for a second. Arnold's going to take off and get sacked. Who got in there? Is that Abbott? It's Jeremy Abbott with the sack. I mean, there are a number of players real close. But that's already two sacks for the defense. We're making really good pace. Need more tackles for loss, of course. I'm going to run the ball here. It's going to be their mistake. Second 14. Up the middle. Claxton just got tossed. Chad Brink just threw Brett Claxton. Third and 11. We're going to trust man coverage. I feel a little bit bad about it. They're going to run the ball. It's a broken tackle. You got to get outside. I ran past it with Sims, man. These broken tackles are killing me. And then, of course, you know, when I switch on and make a mistake, it doesn't help. Let's play action. Arnold has all day. He's going to lob. And Brandon Kelly's got at least a foot down. And a really, really nice catch. He seems to be a really good player. Pitch left. Get over there. To tackle, but are they going to say he lost a yard? Okay. Zaire Cruz, the safety with the TFL. So we don't really need that. Let's go goal line and just get all defensive linemen out there. Second and goal from the one. They've got a bunch of receivers. I mean, they're an empty. I don't feel good about this. We had a guy jump offsides. He's going to run! And Oakley saves a touchdown. I'm worried that we were offsides. Offside. Stupid team, dude. This team sucks. Corey Blackburn. I come out in goal line. He never plays. He finally sees the field in this formation, this personnel group. Makes a stupid mistake. Second and goal from, the half-yard line. And we almost jumped offsides again. We did jump offside. I mean, this is the least disciplined team of all time. It's a touchdown anyway. Devin Blackman. I mean, we get these trash players on the field. Like, even worse than the actual usual guys we got out there. Ugh, this team. 17-3. Second and 13. Throwing a little shallow cross. Burgess, nice catch this time. We got 9. Let's go hurry up. We really need a first down, man. We cannot afford to go down to these guys too much. Just because, like, it's not like they are worse than us. They're plus 10 overall, right? But this is the team that we got to be able to hang with. My quarterback is so bad. Isaiah Smiley. I don't see what real choice I have other than to punt. We are already down 17-3. Let's see what they come out in. Also, you know what I could do? I think I mentioned this in a previous game and then didn't do it. Is putting in Steven Williams at quarterback because he's actually fast. He can't throw the ball at all. But he's fast. So, faster. We might be able to run the ball or at least scramble. We're going to try it. We're going to try it. We got 76 speed out here. We'll see what we can do. Running up the middle. Steven Williams, look at the speed. 12-yard scramble for Steven Williams. We have some strategy. We have some strategy now. This might be the new QB1. Just pound the rock and run read option. Force them to make decisions. I mean, it doesn't work if they do that, though. I mean, will we be able to even... Oh, he's a lefty? He's a lefty? We're going to scramble. Steven Williams. Nice gain there. Is he injured? He looked injured. Yep, he's definitely injured. Isaiah Smiley's back out here on third down. Dude, he wasn't injured anytime we had him at receiver, as Phillips just can't catch the ball. We got to catch the ball, man. We got to go for this, too. Strange shoulder for Steven Williams. Okay. We run the ball here. We're going to have to. Fourth and three. Smiley up the middle. Smiley's got room. First down and more for what is effectively now the third string quarterback. We're going to go with Holman for now, who is not actually the quarterback. Should be. It should be Smiley still. Okay. Going to battle. They played the QB. Gain of four. We're going to get the fullback involved. Briggs right up the gut. Broken tackle. Willie Briggs, backup running back. I mean, just went through people. We've got over 100 yards on the ground now. What we need are receiving yards. Steven Williams is back in. I mean, we can just have our guys catch. It'd be way easier to pick up yardage through the air. All right, little play action jet sweep here. I know what snap the ball is. That's good coverage. 0 for 6 on third down today. These are not numbers you look for. We got to get it to somebody. Slant open. Good ball. And a completion. Tyson Phillips with the 11-yard catch. Had a drop earlier, I believe. And you could say that about pretty much the entire team. First and goal. We got to get it in here. Okay. 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 That's a good throwaway. Play action on second and goal. Look how many D linemen they have in. Quick throw, and it's intercepted by Bullock in the end zone. I know, like, it's just tough, man, not having a QB that can make throws. It really is. And I know where we are, but I couldn't just hold the ball in the pocket. We would have been sacked. There was no time to scramble. Just a bad throw, and that's the story of this franchise, this dynasty so far. This guy's can't make throws, and I feel like I'm all over that. Arnold gonna take off. Wow, he's got space too. We need the football on the ground there. They gonna call that a first down? Arnold gonna take off again, and he gets sacked. Third sack of the game. Ryan Haynes, the left end, is the one who brought him down this time. And that is a really, really nice play to effectively end the first half. Arnold facing pressure, throws to the back, and he is tackled. That's the end of the second quarter, end of the first half. Down 17-3. We don't get the football to start. Half number two, unfortunately. We got to play better. We got to play better. I can't believe I'm saying this, but we need Dorian Hood. He is the most accurate quarterback on the team by a mile, and he's so inaccurate, it's ridiculous, but he's the best we got. Man, our kickoff team has been bad today. We need to fill these gaps a little bit better when they run the football. This is a very odd blitz we're sending. It's a run up the middle. Trying to get over there. We just can't make the tackle, man. Oh, God, that's frustrating. Ed Arnold. We're getting torched by a dude named Ed. Run left. Get outside. Jeez. The only time I want to get beat by ED is a Saturday night when I've had a few too many. Not by Ed Arnold. Some white FCS quarterback I don't know why I needed to add that he's white, but it's true. Why? I mean, why leave it out, right? Option play. Good tackle, Claxton. Run right. Claxton, nice tackle. There we go, Brett. Third and seven. We are getting after him this time. Let's actually flip this so Claxton's blitzing. I can use your young. He's a little bit faster. And we're facing pressure. Let's go, Brett. We're not facing pressure. Ed was. Is that even? I think it was Brett Claxton. They showed number 21 in that little replay. But I think Brett came just screaming up the middle, made the play. This is not a gimme of a field goal. I think it's makeable, but it's not a gimme. Let's see if they make it. Kick up and wide right. Never had a chance. I mean, it was sneaking back in there at the end a little bit, but it was wide right the entire time. Okay. All right. Dorian Hood back in the game for the second half. Okay, they're not covering X. Oh, it's a QB draw. Damn. I didn't have time to get out of it. Let's see what we have here. Want to throw it. It's intercepted. We just don't have that. We just don't have it. I keep fooling myself into thinking that's a throw we can make, and we just can't. Just can't. Over the middle and dropped. See, I know it's like run the ball, run the ball, run the ball. You gotta run the ball. I'm trying to accomplish the goals for the recruit that visited. So I really need the 250 passing yards, or I'd like to have it for those extra points. I think they're pretty big. So trying to make that happen. Nice tackle, Brett. So the sad reality is that I will continue to try and throw the ball. So maybe I have to make smarter throws. Claxton! I don't know how I didn't intercept that. This seems like a bit more of a makeable field goal. Similar distance. We'll see if the kicker has it. Kick is up and drifting off the post. No good. What do college kickers do? They miss. Thought that one was going to be in. Nope. I'm telling you, I think it's impossible to throw the ball unless it's a slip screen. Safety coming up. We might be able to do something here. We got numbers. Trey Battle. Be a little bit faster than a defensive lineman, man. How do we get chased down there? Third and three. To Battle. Nowhere to go. We're going for it on fourth down. We're down 17-3. This team continues to... I don't even want to say that I'm disappointed because I know that they suck. But man, you expect slightly more. I mean, we're averaging 2.1 yards per carry with Trey Battle. I saw somebody in the comments be like, he's going to be a legend. Yeah, right. We're getting outside with Hood. Get up the field. Dorian Hood searching for contact. 14-yard run. Oh my God. I got to show you this in replay. I have to. I was waiting to throw the seam. It was going to get open. It just was. Was going to get open. Look at this BS. Oh my goodness, man. Tight end is going to have a step. Look at this. Just stops for no reason. Look at that. He was supposed to just run straight. It was not a double move. Just kind of like trips over his own feet. Stutters a couple times. And at that point, we were getting sacked. Oh, man. 1-for-8 on third down. This is third and 19. And that, I mean, could have been intercepted. As you'll notice, the throw wasn't anywhere near where it was supposed to be. And now we have to punt. Dude, we just can't throw the ball. I don't know how we're going to get 250 yards passing when we struggle to get 50. Dude, it's hard. It is so hard. Oh, what a weird run. And what a really nice effort there. Didn't make the play, of course. But that was Malik James, I think, who popped him back. We couldn't wrap up, and so they gained 7. But, man, it'd be nice if we could have some guys that can tackle. Brett Claxton, I want to say, is like 9 right now. And even he misses tackles sometimes. We might have been offsides. Ran right past that somehow. That's a first? Wow. A lot I'm surprised about on that play. Harden in motion. Going to be an option, and they're actually just going to throw the ball. McLaurin is open and has 22. That was my man. I just thought they were running the ball. I got confused with the motion, and then I thought the quarterback was going to run. It's something. Harden in motion. This actually is a run, and nowhere to go. Jordan Young, actually an outside linebacker, I believe, coming in to make that play. Really, really nice. And it's second and 13. I don't want to say that we're out of this game yet because a touchdown, you know, puts us right back in it. But it just doesn't feel like we can move the ball through the air. And that's what we have to for the recruit, you know. Dude, I'm holding triangle. What's happening? How do we not make a tackle? How is that not an interception? I have so many questions. Dude, they keep going at it empty, but they'll run the ball from this somehow. Because Harden will come in motion. Look at this. Look at this. Trash. Ed Arnold tackled for loss. That's a really big stop. Because they've missed a couple field goals in this game. This has been at about the same distance they keep missing from. And I would way rather them try the field goal and even make it than try to get the fourth down conversion and definitely make it. Up the middle. Kick is also up the middle. Very easily in. And we are down 20-3. We need a touchdown right now. We need to get lucky. We need a coverage breakdown. Miscommunication in the secondary. Something to get big yardage through the air really quickly. I mean, we've only scored 3 points this game. This was a game we needed to be competitive in. No, not competitive really at all. Just can't throw the ball. I mean, it's been terrible. I've never seen the quarterback struggle this much, but it's been brutal. Like, look at this, man. Look at these throws. I'm telling you, it is absolute agony. We're throwing that. It's intercepted. Where do these guys come from? It was a design screen. I thought we had a step of throwing 3 interceptions this game. I believe, right? It feels like at least 3. It was a design screen, but we have steps over the top. He just doesn't have the arm. He's got an actual noodle. I'm going to keep trying it. Eventually, he will get the football there. It's just the percentage chance of having it happen seems to be incredibly low. He can't even hit receivers out of the backfield, right? In the form of running backs. Nice tackle, Ezekiel Sims. All it takes is one, though. All it takes is one. We need the yardage. We're not going to get it. We are not going to come close to getting it. It's going to take so much luck. We keep jumping off sides this game, too. I mean, what's happening? All right, 5 receivers. Is McLaurin going to come in motion here? He's not. It's going to be a screen, and it's going to be nearly a sack. I mean, our defense just stepped up in a huge way. That was a terrible 3-and-out from FCS Southeast. Looked like that was probably Dorian Hood playing quarterback. The way that drive just went. We need one of these passes down the field to be complete. Need one of them. I mean, anything. We need yards through the air. We get sacked. Man. I know I should be running. I'm not going to run. I want the 250 yards. I've explained that enough at this point. I'm not going to give up on it. It should be about time to. I don't think we're going to win the game. I mean, I got 2 o'clock on because I don't think we're going to win the game. I'm trying to throw it. Jeez. It's 3rd and 28. The O-line can't hold a block. It's brutal right now, man. It is brutal. We're going to keep battling to block, maybe. I'll tell you, I don't think that's going to do anything, but we're going to do it. Williams switching on, making the tackle is, I think, the corner. But nice catch by Steven Williams. Just needs somebody to catch it. 4 verticals, keep the back in the block, and just hope that we get a decent enough throw. Williams, nice catch over the middle. This is what we're doing. We found it. We found it. 4 verticals. Running back in the block. In zone coverage, they just move all over the place. We're going. Shot to the end zone. Burgess! Mossed him! We're coming alive here in the 4th. I just got to switch on and make the plays, clearly. That's all that is. Nice catch, Eric Burgess. He had a big drop earlier, but caught that one. Peculiar. Lestree Collins up the middle. Inside pass lead. Got to be a touchdown. Elgin Collins TD. We're fighting back. We are fighting back. We missed the extra point. I mean, all I can do, really, is just go straight down all the way back up. That's all I can do is just that, right? And he missed anyway. To run up the middle. Oh, we got to make that tackle. That counts enough. They're clearly going to be in run the ball mode. So we got to be in tackling mode. Can we go big hits conservative? Strip ball conservative? Listen, we're not going to force the ball out anyway. We might as well just try and not have them break a ton of tackles on us. Second and seven. We're going to bring the safety up. Nice play. Brett Claxton had some help too. 11 tackles for Brett Claxton in this game. 94 hit him. I think it was Pop Jackson, I want to say. Is 94? Yeah, Pop Jackson. Now it's third and 11. I think they can still run the ball here feasibly from this formation. They're going to go underneath. Claxton can't get the ankles. Wow, nobody can. And Sims racing down the sideline, trying to catch him. Won't catch him. It's a touchdown. We had an opportunity. We just didn't make the tackle. That's all it is. We've seen it so many times this game. Right underneath. Just couldn't make the tackle. Back to my four verticals offense. Yeah, that should have been picked probably. They were playing it that time. But I got to keep the running back in the block. So I'm kind of in a tough spot there. Let me put him on a streak. Make that linebacker make a tough play. Man, I really want to just get that ball past him. Couldn't do it. Third and 10. Oh, we got to get out of this. Barely able to snap the ball. We're facing pressure. That football came out and it rolled out of bounds. Why would we punt on fourth and 16? Down 27. I got to call a timeout. We have to try and go for this. Have to. We're 4-for-4 on fourth down. It's our best down by a lot. Somebody get open here. Nobody got open. We couldn't even get the throw off. I mean, I had the running back in the block. I don't know if he picked up anybody. God! This was a frustrating game. I bet it was frustrating to watch too, but like, as much as some of these decisions are bad on my part, I really am limited by the team, man. It's been a ton of drops. It's been a ton of missed tackles. I mean, even with Brett Claxton on the big TD, where I thought I covered him well, and then he juked back over to the left and I missed the diving tackle. We got 73 speed, man, that middle linebacker. It's just really, really tough to be able to change directions and make plays with these guys. It's really difficult. Arnold to the end zone, picked off by Justin Santos. Just go down. That might be one of the first interceptions we've actually seen in this series. I think I might have the only other one with Brett Claxton. Justin Santos, the free safety, stealing that one away. I need time, man. You gotta block. You have to block. I just don't think I have anything. They're all over the four verts now. I mean, some of these DBs are running the routes for my receivers. I wanted to go to X there. I'm telling you, we didn't have the throw. I've tried to force that in all game where it certainly seems open and it's not somehow. I've seen it all game. I've seen it all dynasty so far. Play action on fourth and eight. Who wouldn't fall for that? We're scrambling just to try and keep it alive. We had some throw possibilities. With the percentage of throwing a very bad ball, just had to take the, or at least what I thought to be the safer option. First down and 10. Up the seam! We had it and Collins dropped it. Finally got the actual pass that I wanted and know that quarterbacks can make this game. Totally missed it. I know it probably sounds like I'm complaining a lot. That's not really, like, the goal. Because I know the team's really bad. I'm just trying to explain what's happening. R1 was open, and it's just sails over his head by about a country mile. So, what do you want from me? What do you want? Just wasn't even close, man. He airmailed it. I mean, it would have been a better throw to number 5. So I think it was Steven Williams who was super covered. These QBs, man, I mean, it's brutal. I can't wait for season 2. I can't wait because we'll actually have some better players. It still is going to be a bad team, but the players will be at least a little bit better, which, oh man, I can't tell you how nice that's going to be. I can't tell you how nice that's going to be. We did get 3 sacks, which we needed to, right? We were so close to getting more coach XP. We're going to be a little bit shy. As you can see, through 4 picks, passed for just over 120 yards. Didn't exactly get the goal we were looking for, but we tried. I really did try. Rushing, I mean, couldn't get anything going with the running backs. Like, Trey Battle averaged 2 yards per carry. Briggs had 7 on a fullback dive, and with the quarterbacks, we were taking off a decent bit. It's like, what, 11 times total? Receiving. A couple nice catches in there at the end. Touchdown for Elgin Collins. And then defensively, Claxton had 2 tackles for loss, 2 for Cruz, 1 for Jordan Young, and then 2 for Ezekiel Sims. Do we have 3 with D linemen? Glover's 1, Abbott's 1, Haynes is 1. So that's 3 total, and we got 3 sacks with D linemen. So we should be getting all the goals for that D lineman. And then we had interception for Justin Santos too, which is kind of nice. Yeah, that's a really, really big loss to not that great of a team. We do have a bye week in week 7. Season 1's not going to take too long. We are, you know, almost to the end of it. And you'll see when we simulate to week 8, because we're in a bye in week 7, how many games we actually have left. Because there are a lot of bye weeks in here based on not having, you know, any chance for any bowl games or playoffs or anything like that. We are 0-4. Oh, Coach Dengus is level 4, and we are officially in a recruiting battle with 4 schools for Jonathan Horton, 1 school for Joe Downing, who came to visit, Patrick Payne. We got points for Kyle Holloway visiting, and Landon Owens, a linebacker, is ready to visit. So here's what we're going to do in the bye week. We are going to go into coach skill trees here and go into head coach and get 100% of a prospect's true skills each week for 50 points. Boom! Scouting 2 of 3. And then I would usually go with the opener, right? But we're like midway through the season. So I think I'll probably get the closer next based on when we're going to have points. That's what I think is going to work out. Yeah, we're in week 7 already, right? So we go into recruiting. We have 34 current targets. Let me decide who we're going to have a real shot at and who we won't. So it's going to be really important to keep these points where they are to stay in the battle here and even get some of these players. Joe Downing, I mean, he's got to be a member of this team. Has to. That was a huge week for us. We jumped ahead of Colorado. So that is major. Derek Schultz, do I keep dumping points into him? He's just a well-balanced player. He's not that good. He's decent. Kyle Holloway is all but going to come here. That's really nice. I mean, he's got to be like, what, 99% locked? 68. Let's see where these guys that I added down at the end of last episode are. So we are, I mean, we're in the race for some of these guys, really. Robert Bush we can remove. I mean, there's no shot to get him. He's going to go to Ohio State, probably. We're not going to get Jay Wilson either. Nick Jackson. You know, I suppose there's a chance there, but I think it's unlikely. We would really have to dump in points to have a shot at him. Ooh, Joel Lewis, -4 overall. Probably take him off the board. Nick Jackson's going to be real tough to get him. I mean, we're competing with some top schools there. I just don't think that's possible. What about Andy Byers? We're in the lead for him. Should we see his true abilities here? Gem. +5 overall. Ooh. 84 throw power, 75 throw accuracy. He's a JUCO player, so we're not going to have him for a ton of time, right? But he'd be a really, really good player to have right away. We're getting the lead a little bit more on Bruce Clemens. This would be a really big grab for us. I think he's going to be awesome. Marvin Johnson, we don't really know too much about. No, he's fast. He's a 67 overall. That's pretty big, though. Might put some points into him. Ooh, 93 speed and pretty good coverage here for Bobby Anderson. Let's take some points maybe out of Marvin Johnson so we can offer a scholarship to Bobby Anderson. Yeah, definitely might move some things around here. Added some new potential recruits to the bottom. Some of these guys were lower lock percentage. Some of these guys were decent athletes. Like Jim Stiegel ran like 4.44 or something. And I think 89 speed at linebacker could be really, really nice. It's not really much of a tackler right now. A bit of a project for sure. But I just wanted to find out about some of these guys and then potentially offer scholarships. That's one we want to offer a scholarship to. Greg Hall, 85 speed, 84 hit power, great acceleration. Yeah, we're going to try and get him for sure. Craig Jackson has 95 acceleration. That's kind of insane. Add another JUCO guy here, Joel Pitts. What does he look like? He is 6'4", 246, built like a linebacker. He's got good pursuit, hit power, tackling's real high. Not the fastest player, 82 power moves. That is a rush outside linebacker. Let's offer him a scholarship. Found a bit of a good player here in Barrett Reed. Offer him a scholarship too. We don't really have a lot of receivers. I didn't scout a ton of position players or skill players, right? I didn't scout a ton of skill players. So we're building through the trenches right now. So you see advanced week, we have Hawaii, San Jose State University, App State, that's through their rank now. UNLV, that's 4. FCS Northwest, that's 5. San Diego State, that's 6. Nevada, that's 7. And that's it. We have 7 games for the rest of the season. We're officially halfway through. Of course, still the update that we're in a recruiting battle with many schools, but there are new recruits that are ready to visit, which is nice. And of course, some XP for finding a gem as well. That's always nice. Let's see where we are before we end the episode. Yeah, it's still just a dead heat for some of these guys. I'm not sure if anything will change. We just got to stay in this battle until either other teams drop out or the offseason where we can spend a ton of XP to try and bring these different players in. So we'll try that. We'll try that. And let's see if we're actually in the race for these guys down at the bottom that I added. So Clinton Darby didn't offer him a scholarship. He was just fast. Didn't really offer me a whole lot more than that. So, not super interested in him. Ben Lewis, I did offer on. He's also just fast, but he is 6'2", from a pipeline state. Figure we get extra points that way. And we would have to really throw in points to get him. Probably not going to get him. Craig Jackson, we could be in the mix for. He's decent, unexceptional, but he'd be one of the better players we have currently. Greg Hall's the big one. I'm going to put 500 points in him. If we want to get in this battle, I mean, we gotta put in big points. Oh, Nick Jackson's a 79. He's so good at everything. And he's also not a JUCO player. So we'd be able to develop him for a while. I don't think we're going to be able to steal him from Tulsa. He's going to go to Tulsa. We got to break that up. But that is going to do it for this episode, guys. Hope you enjoyed. I'm having a lot of fun. I like the idea of the potential long-term for the team, and that's kind of what I'm holding on to right now. I recognize that season one is going to be a struggle, but we're still looking for win number one. Maybe we'll come against Hawaii. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you in the next one. Take it easy. It's insane. I hit it at the park. Bend bones. See me high step to the end zone. My life like a game. Nintendo. Playing with the best.